Now, over 50 kidnapped victims in the custody of a notorious bandit in Zamfara State, Bello Tuji, have regained the freedom. Co-chairman of the State Committee on Finding Lasting Solutions to Banditry, Dr. Abdullahi Shinkafi, confirmed the development. Shinkafi said the victims were released unconditionally due to military airstrikes on bandits' camps in Zamfara and Sokoto Forest. Now, according to report, two bandits died from the onslaught, while others sustained severe injuries. The police has said arrangements are being made to evacuate all freed victims to the state capital, Gozo, for profiling and medical treatment before they are released to their families. We are now being joined by Ibrahim Dosara, the Commissioner for Information in Zamfara State. Good evening to you. Many thanks for joining us on PLUS News Now. Commissioner, if you can hear us, can you bring us up to speed about the victims who were released today? Was there any sort of negotiations on or ransom paid?
Yeah. Good evening.
Yeah, good evening to you.
Yes, it's nice having me this time around. The issue of the rescued kidnapped victims in Zamfara State is an appreciating effort. And it happened due to the intense pressure from the military, who are currently undertaking onslaught into the enclaves of the bandits. And as a result, the imprint of the bandits, Fiji, had to abandon the kidnapped victims. And then later, use the repentant bandit who collaborates with the police and the vigilante recently constituted by the government to go and rescue these people, and the government received them. We are currently taking care of them in terms of medication, in terms of food, in terms of clothing, and giving them lecture to psychologically comfort them before they are handed over to the sole administrators of their respective local government councils, and who will later reunite them with their respective families. And we are hoping anytime soon we will hand them over to the sole administrators for onward reunification with their families.
Okay, you just said anytime soon. Can you be more specific as regards the time frame when they are going to be reintegrated? And besides, you said you're actually giving them some sort of care, that's some food. What about the issue of psychological trauma? What are you doing in that regard so that when these victims are reintegrated into society, they will not have some sort of post-traumatic disorder?
That is why I said we are giving them lectures to psychologically comfort them, to make them feel like any other persons in the society. And there, when they go back to their family, we have also imams and Islamic religious leaders who also preach on them to make them relieve from the trauma they went through, and also feel free and relate to other people within the society.
So specifically now, given terms, really, how soon would they be reintegrated back, to their homes and their families?
Like I said, anytime soon. When we understand they are okay, then we send them back to their families. It could be tomorrow, it could be within the weekend. It all depends on the situation we see they are.
All right, let's still talk about security and the fight against it in your state specifically. Now, the president has come out to say that there's no room for state policing. You know, specifically, what is the government of Zamfara State doing to ensure that residents are secure and they can go about their legitimate businesses while, you know, going to bed with both eyes closed?
You see, the issue of security is something that you cannot come on media and start exposing the plans you make, because once the other opponents or the enemies heard your plans, they will also re-strategize. So we'll not be able to tell exactly the planning we are making. But what we are saying, we are assuring the general public that the people of Zamfara State will be fully secured through the process and strategies we are making. We are mapping a lot of plans that we will make sure that these bandits are neutralized or they are pushed out of Zamfara State.
So invariably, are you telling us candidly that the residents of Zamfara State can actually go about their lawful businesses without having to fear about being attacked anytime by bandits or kidnappers or just general criminals?
Yes, like I told you, Zamfara State government has the security of lives and property of the citizenry as its top agenda. And it is its topmost priority. And as such, we are making a lot of consultations with the military high command, the presidency, and even the authorities of the neighboring countries to make sure that we collaborate together, have a kind of synergy that will be able to make sure that these bandits are pushed out of Zamfara State or do not have any means of getting supplies of their weapons and other necessary needs. We also make sure that we pressurize on the federal government to give us large number of troops so that we have enough manpower in the security sector to be able to neutralize the bandits. And the measures we took in the past has helped greatly in preventing the bandits from getting the information from the informants and the collaborators that do give them information and other support. We have dealt with that issue seriously following the measures we took in the past, where we blocked mobile networks and also prevent people from buying fuels and supply of all these things to the forest. We have achieved a lot in this sector, and we are making other plans to make sure that these people are not given a breathing chance, so that our people will be free and they go about in their normal businesses.
All right, thank you so much, Commissioner, for your time.
You are welcome.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.